just if you can reminisce and take us back to that run to the Final Four and just how special that was for you and the confidence it gives you going into these pre-draft workouts.
It was real special for me. Just, you know, when I got to USC, we like the worst team in the conference, and, you know, nobody thought about South Carolina as basketball. So, you know, to finally, you know, get that chance in the tournament and then make a run in the tournament, that was the ultimate goal for me when I first got there. So it was special just to show that my hard work paid off, so it was good.
So when you get together with your team and you start to focus on the draft and you're meeting with teams, what's the one thing you want to show?
Just my defensive side, just showing how well I can guard and, you know, being able to guard multiple positions and the amount of the competitiveness I bring and the energy and the effort, and also being able to create for others and make the open shot.
What's the one thing where maybe your people said you need to get better at this so people can see you and do it?
Making a three-point shot at a consistent rate. You know, I'm not really known to be a shooter, and over my years at South Carolina, I gotten better at it. And so that's one thing I still continue to grow and get better at.
How much difference is the line?
That's a lot of difference. It's a big difference. You know, college three, I almost was shooting that without even jumping. Whereas now, you know, you got to put your whole body into it. And, you know, you see, like, all the great players shoot from almost half court in the games, make it look like a free throw, and, you know, we're struggling to just make the regular three. So it's tough.
What was it like today with this workout? It looked like you guys were competing but having a lot of fun and kind of pulling for each other.
Yeah, it was fun, man. It was, you know, everybody was competing. Everybody played hard. And, you know, it was fun just to be back playing with PJ for the first time since the tournament. So that was good to, you know, finally catch up with him.
So that was the first workout you guys had together?
Yeah, that was the first one. We had Orlando, but it was in two different groups. So this was the first one we've been in together and was on the same team. So that was cool.
Any memorable highlights together for this one?
For this one? No, not this one. But for the season, plenty. He saved us a lot. He saved us a lot. So it was good.
How do you think being a four-year player can help benefit you if you get a chance to get drafted and play in the league?
I'm older, so, you know, I feel like I can come in and compete at a high level, you know, with being already strong and, you know, some things that 18-year-olds can't bring to the game with the knowledge and also being able to guard, you know, a lot of younger guys when they first come in. They haven't really had those 4 years to understand, you know, guarding is a big thing. You know, they play 1 year and that 1 year they was just shooting shots, all they was the man. And so, you know, I understand what my role is going to be. And being able to contribute early instead of having to go and work my way up, I think I could come in off somebody's bench and being able to be that extra defender.
The Lakers have had some recent success, late first round, second round, in recent years with Clarkson, Nance, and Zubats. What do you take away from their kind of journey and how they've kind of carved it so far early in their career?
You know, they're young, and I feel like, you know, I could benefit a lot coming here, you know, being that, you know, that older but young player that could fit this team on the defensive end. You know, I could be that lockdown defender for them, and you know, and I feel like that's one thing that they need on their roster is a lockdown wing defender. And with me being older, but also a young guy in the league, so that I'll fit right in with the team, I think I could help the team a lot.